The Makerere University School of Public Health has today released findings from an evaluation study they have conducted on implementation of the HIV self-testing program by the Ministry of Health. The initiative is a game changer as far as HIV testing is concerned, given their demand in the public. HIV self-testing services started in 2018 and the government has distributed 1.2 million self-test kits for the period of 2020 to 2022. But research has established an even distribution of the kits which are allotted to Kampala and upper health facilities at the coast of upcountry areas and health center twos which are in dire need of the services.
With a small number in health center threes, but one thing to note is that there were no kits identified at health center two level. Yet these are now the health facilities that are closer to the population. So that means if you need a kit from a government facility, you have to go to a health center three. This is the lowest you can where you can find a kit. And we needed to inform them about this because that kind of distribution means there are some people who are not reached.
The study, which was based on 47 health facilities from 15 districts, has revealed that 8% of HIV-positive results by self-testing kits turn negative after doing a confirmatory test.
Some 8% of those who had been positive on the kit, when they went for confirmatory testing, the result turned negative. Now, that's like, isn't the kit a wrong one? Isn't it a, doesn't the kit have a problem? My answer would be no. All test kits, wherever they are, whether they're for malaria or HIV or anything, there's an element of error somewhere. There's an element of error. It's not 100%. It's always about 95, 92, 96, depending on the manufacturer of the kit. So probably that 8% can be explained along those lines.
Dr. Joseph Matovu, the lead investigator in this study, noted that kits are accurate and attributed gaps to errors made by the users of the test kits due to lack of proper knowledge on usage. He also emphasized a need for all users of these rapid test kits to report their results to medical facilities.
We are inviting the media. People out there don't know much about self-testing. They probably have heard a bit of it, but they are not very sure how it is and how it works. But want to inform them that when we did this evaluation, we realized that majority who tested, we identified so many people that were positive for the first time. These were linked to care, and there were very few challenges, emotional challenges really, largely emotional, and a bit of sexual violence related to sexual intercourse.
Meanwhile, scientists are concerned with the increased cases of new infections in adolescents and young women. The new research indicates that adolescent girls and young women aged between 24 to 25 account for 36% of the new infections. In another study conducted to review interventions implemented by the Ministry of Education to keep girls in school and protect them from HIV/AIDS, have not yielded significant strides in districts when the program is taking course. Story compiled by Fred Kajabi for the news.